pick you up, clean you up, turn you around, and use you for his service.
Amen.
We serve in awesome. Pray with me. Heavenly Father, we just thank you right now for allowing us to come into your house once again. Father, bless us all to be better. Bless us all to be more receptive to your word and willing to do what you have us to do. Have been a hollow being as I speak to your people. Realize that they are not mine, but they are yours. Father, bless the words of my mouth. Allow you to be up front as I decrease and stand in the back. Father, bless, heal, deliver, and set free. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, if you got a Bible handy, turn with me to the book of John. Matthew, Mark, Luke, who?
John.
The book of John, and let us rise, the sixth chapter. The sixth chapter, the 11th verse. Sixth chapter, the 11th verse. Matter of fact, back up to the 10th verse. John 6:10. And Jesus said, make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in the place. So the men sat down in number about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves when he had given what? Thanks. He distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down. And likewise for the fishes as much as they were. 12, when they were filled, he said unto his disciples, gather up the fragments that there remain, that nothing be lost. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and application of his word. Go ahead and take your seats. What I want to highlight today is that we all need to have a miracle on our mind. Somebody say, I need a miracle.
I need a miracle.
On my mind.
On my mind.
We all have to have a miracle on our mind. But I put this scripture out today, and I want to really look at the 11th verse and highlight that. It says, and Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks. You and I, we've got to understand, we need to realize that anytime a miracle happens, it is preceded by us giving thanks. See, I know Thanksgiving just passed. Many of us just got done eating our patty pies and all our turkeys and drink. As a matter of fact, I got an announcement. I got a Detroit pie today. A sweet potato pie. And I'm so excited. I'm going to do a review. I ain't did no patty review, but I'm going to do a review on this sweet potato pie I got. It's a Detroit special. Let the church say amen. So I'm excited about that. Back to the message. You and I, we've got to walk in a spirit of thanksgiving at all times. I know the holidays come around and we want to be extra thankful. We want to be extra helpful and all those things. But there's something that we have to have on a full-time basis. You and I have to understand, if you want a miracle for God, if you want God to do something in your life, if you want something miraculous, we have to walk in thanksgiving. Most often, we don't come to church until God is doing something in our lives or when something bad is going on, but we ought to be coming through the good and the bad and still walking in a spirit of thanksgiving. Let the church say amen. Quite often we complain. That's why we haven't had any traction when it comes to the things of God. That's why we haven't had any upward mobility. That's why we're still in a dead-end job, because we don't even give God thanks for where we are right now. Amen. You expect God to move you, to motivate you, to put you in higher places and higher heights, and you ain't even thanking him for the situation that you got right now. How many of you understand that your situation, there are people in this world who would love to be where you are right now? In America, poverty is almost like royalty if you go to a third world country, amen. We have a luxury. We can go and turn water on in the house and it runs. Amen, somebody. It don't stop. You ain't got to measure. You can go and take a shower till you wrinkle up on the outside. Amen. We can do all these things, but we walk around with a spirit of not being faithful. We act as if somebody owes us something. And guess what? Nobody owes you anything. You want your hand held? No, you need to start thanking God. See, I wake up in the morning with aches and pains, and I thank God for the aches and pains. Amen. I thank God because through those aches and pains, I know that he's a healer and I'm going to be healed. But not only that, I understand that I'm still in the land of the living. Amen. Amen. So I've got something to shout out. So many of us are not thankful. We cry all the time. We complain all the time. We gripe and moan all the time, always in somebody's business, and not thankful for our own business. Amen. Come here, though, if you tend to your own stuff, be thankful in your own stuff, God will handle that. But we too busy trying to worry about somebody else's stuff, be thankful for somebody else's stuff, coveting somebody else's stuff when our own stuff needs to be handled. Tell your neighbor, I gotta have a miracle. On my mind. Three things I want you to know today before you leave. Some of you take notes and some of you don't. It's fine. Three things I want you to know. The first thing I want you to know is that miracles await. Somebody say miracles await.
Miracles await.
Didn't say Pastor Cooper. Okay, the ADI. Praise the Lord. The rest of y'all say Pastor Cooper. Praise the Lord. Hebrews 11:6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. What does that mean? When you and I are in a place where we need something from God, we need to be seeking after him. So many of us are seeking after stuff. We're seeking after riches. We're seeking after women. We're seeking after men. We're seeking after both. Let the church say amen. We're seeking after so many things, but we're not seeking after God. And we understand, we should understand, the reason our situations have not changed is because we're seeking after the wrong stuff. Let the church say amen. You can't just be seeking after God on Sunday in church, seeking after him on Wednesday in Bible study, and expect him to turn your situation around. Amen. You need to be seeking after him when your friends call you with that junk trying to get you to go out and do this and do that. When you know the Lord said, you need to stop. Amen. You wonder why things keep falling apart because you're not diligently seeking him. The scripture said, when you seek him, he'll reward you. I want mine. Don't know what you want, but I want mine, Auntie Shirley. I want all of my rewards, so I'm going to diligently seek him. Somebody say, I've got a miracle on my mind. The second thing I want you to understand is miracles happen. Somebody say, miracles happen. You say, oh, no, they don't. Yes, they do. I got some biblical proof, and I'm going to give you some practical proof as well. If you look at the book of John, 11 chapter 41st verse, it says, so they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. Well, in the scripture, what exactly am I talking about? In this scripture, Jesus' friend Lazarus had already died. Jesus' friend Lazarus was in the grave. He was in the tomb. Jesus' friend Lazarus had begun to stink. Guess what his family needed? They needed a miracle. Jesus said, look at this, roll away the stone. But not only did he say roll away the stone, but after they did that, he gave thanks. Listen, Lazarus was still dead, but Jesus gave thanks. Lazarus was still laying there, but Jesus gave thanks. Somebody gonna get it in a second. Lazarus was still in the grave, stinking, and then Jesus gave thanks. And what happened after Jesus gave thanks? God moved on his behalf. Amen. You and I need to start giving God thanks in the midst of our dead situations. Stop waiting for him to move, but thank him before he moves. Because if you thank him before he moves, he might move more than what you expect. Amen. We got this little faith, but we need to start exercising some big faith and thank him in the midst. Jesus walked up, looked at the situation, said, move the stone. God's got this, but let me thank him because I know he's about to move on my behalf. Some of y'all need to start thanking God right now because you're in a bad situation. Some of y'all need to start thanking God right now because you're in a dead end relationship. Some of you need to start thanking God right now because you're broke as a joke. Your money is funny. Some of you need to thank God right now because your kid is a mess. Some of you need to thank God right now because you a mess. We need to thank God in the midst of our situation. Thank God in the midst of our circumstances. And thank God at all times. Don't just thank him when you got the victory. Thank him before the victory. Somebody say, I've got a miracle on my mind. I've got a miracle on my mind. The third thing, is miracles are mine. Somebody say, they're mine. Miracles are mine. Miracles will be in my life, not just other people's life. You got to profess that. Somebody talk with me. Say, miracles are mine. I know you want one, but I'm telling you, miracles are mine. I serve a God who's going to work on my behalf. Somebody say, miracles are mine. Miracles are mine. Don't just look for somebody else to have one. You need to look for one. You said the whole thing. Well, I appreciate you. Well, Pastor, prove it. Well, I guess I will. The Bible tells us in Psalms 84:11, for the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. Peep this part. Peep this.
Amen.
You did? Yes. No good thing will he withhold from them who walk uprightly. Well, what does that mean? Somebody should have just shouted when I got done reading that. Because the scripture says when I walk like I'm supposed to walk, he's going to bless me. When I talk how I'm supposed to talk, he's going to bless me. When I live how I'm supposed to live, he's going to bless me. When I do what I'm supposed to do, he's going to bless me. You've got to say miracles are mine. You and I need to be walking in a place where we know he hears us, where he'll move on our behalf. You ain't got to worry about the rent no more when you're walking like him. You ain't got to worry about your family no more when you're talking like him. He said there's nothing he'll withhold from his children who walk upright. Well, he's my daddy, so that means I'm qualified. There's nothing he'll withhold from me when I do what he tells me to do, when I say what he tells me to say, when I go where he tells me to go. You ought to be screaming right now that
circumstance. We've got to get to a place where we thank
God, even when it doesn't feel good. Well, we thank God, even when it doesn't seem good, Ms. Tony. Well, we thank God, even when it looks like everything is going wrong. When it looks like everybody's turned against you. When it looks like everybody's got their mouth on your business, you still need to thank God. We serve an awesome God who's able to heal, who's able to deliver, who's able to set free. Let us all stand. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I got a miracle on my mind. The truly miraculous thing about our initial scripture this morning in John was that this little boy had some fish and some loaves. Jesus took that. He gave thanks for it. Blessed and told them, pass it out to everybody. Now you also have to understand, not only were there 5,000 men there, but how many know there were families there? There were women and children there. It just tells us about the 5,000 men, because you know we got a big appetite at the church, say amen. But they had a straight up fish fry, and it wasn't on a Friday. They had fish for days. When they got done, Jesus said, go and pick up so it doesn't get wasted. Now listen to this. He gave thanks with a little in expectation of a lot. Somebody gonna catch that. He gave thanks with a little in expectation of a lot. I'm gonna say that again. He gave thanks with a little in expectation of a lot. We got to start thanking them with a little. Why would I give you a whole lot of stuff if you ain't even thankful for the little stuff that you got? We're too unthankful. We have to be thankful. If you want a miracle, raise your hand. If there's something going on in your family and you want a miracle, raise your hand. If there's something going on in your home and you want a miracle, something going on your job and you want a miracle, raise your hand. If anything is going on in your life, you ain't got to profess it to me, but if you won't instead and need a miracle, raise your hand. Now let's go to the important part. Give God some thanks right now. Come on, what you got.